According to the World Health Organization, coronaviruses are a large family of viruses which may cause illness in animals or humans. In humans, several coronaviruses are known to cause respiratory infections ranging from the common cold to more severe diseases such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome. COVID-19, however, is a new infectious virus caused by the most recently discovered coronavirus and is closely related to SARS, which existed in 2002 to 2003. It is said that older people and those who have underlying medical symptoms like cardiovascular disease, diabetes, chronic respiratory disease, and cancer are more likely to develop serious illness. However, there have been many cases of young adolescents with perfect health who have been infected by COVID-19. There are roughly 8.75 million cases worldwide, 4.33 million have recovered, and 463,000 have unfortunately died in June 2020. So, as mentioned before, COVID-19 existed in the world in 2002-2003, and it was closely related to severe acute respiratory syndrome with about 8,000 cases and 800 deaths. Most of these were seriously ill, hence it was easier to control, they didn't get to run itself out. And then another coronavirus was Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, which has been occurring inconsistently since it first emerged in 2012. With about 2,500 cases and 900 deaths. The only difference between COVID-19 and the other two coronaviruses is that the scope of disease is broad, with around 80% of cases leading to mild symptoms. This brings the question, if COVID-19 existed before, why was it harder to control? Well, it's partly got to do with how we display our symptoms. Some people are asymptomatic, which means not everyone will show signs of the coronavirus. We were told to stay protected if needed to go outside. We were told to wear masks and gloves and stay approximately 2 meters apart. People's responses to this pandemic have gone accordingly to these rules, yet it was quite comical at the same time. You know, we had this whole thing with a toilet roll. People would wake up really early in the morning just so they could be the first ones to stock up on them. Next thing you know, the whole country was panic buying and we had a great shortage of products. What does this say about us as a collective? Well, we certainly did not have our priorities in check. Our primal instincts must have kicked in where people felt the need to panic buy insane amounts of products unnecessarily. We ran out of masks, we ran out of gloves, we ran out of sanitizer. It was ridiculous. We even had rules where one person was only allowed like 2 products of frozen food. It just really goes to show how selfish some people are in the community that supermarkets had to arrange these rules to stop the panic buying. In a way, this pandemic was like a giant mirror reflecting humanity's faults onto us, and I think we really needed that. It wasn't all that bad though. Due to the great shortage of products, it encouraged many people to create health and food packs to distribute to their neighbors and to those who were unable to leave the homes. The ozone layer even healed since most people stopped traveling by cars. It also encouraged many young people to think creatively as the pandemic caused schools to shut down. Some teenagers ended up starting their own businesses, some returned to their music and art, while others just enjoyed spending their free time playing video games. I think all of our patience was tested through this time and it definitely taught us discipline in some odd way. I think on behalf of the majority of the people working there, we all struggled with stress and trauma. Seeing people suffering on the hospital beds was a norm. Seeing people struggling to breathe was a norm. Witnessing people die was a norm. It was just too much. I think working in such an environment, you'd always know I might get infected at some point by some of the viruses that are going on, because there are always various viruses going on. However, what I think was the most difficult thing now was putting our trust into our communities that they will not leave their homes, because now all this risk that we are going to get infected exists even outside of the hospital. Regarding the mental health, I feel like most of the people working for NHS went into kind of a robot mode in which you just function automatically, because it was so busy. There were so many people coming in all the time, and you just get home, sleep, wake up the next day, and you know that's what you have to do. You know people's lives count on you. You know that all the time working there, but this time the amount of people coming in, it's so much higher. We were invisible before the coronavirus outbreak. People started to recognize how hard we work to support ourselves, our families, and the whole community. In a way, this pandemic gave us what we needed. Communities all over our country were so supportive. They would come out of their homes just on the doorstep, and families would applaud us every Thursday. It was a great feeling. I just hope we never have to go through such a traumatic event again just to have the respect we deserve.